Oh, shoot. You stopped it on me. All right, we're recording. Yes. You guys haven't even been watching anything.
We're recording two games into it.
Yeah.
S. Stoddard is safe. Nate wants to play again. 1 o'clock on the TV or Tim Stoddard? Tim Stoddard.
All right, Tim Stoddard has got a request that Nate Reinhart wants to play some One Pocket with you.
I want $2. I want.
So you took $20 out of him, huh?
Last time I played him.
Shot by Tony.
Ball. Tim Stoddard.
Oh.
He gave me a ball, and I beat him, and I was up like two or four games. I forgot what it was. It was an even number. And he's like, fuck that spot. I ain't spotting you shit no more. So I took away the spot, and he got it back even. I'm like,
yeah, actually, we haven't seen the whole thing. It wasn't. Nope. It was recording.
I said, fine, fuck it. This player.
Oh, okay. Sorry about that.
I beat him 3-0.
I think it was just maybe internally recording. Thanks.
Yeah, actually, we haven't seen the whole thing.
All right, Tony. Tony takes it. Good shot.
The rules change. It's that expression.
All right, updated score. Michael up 2-1. Tony's got a chance after Michael's dry break or scratching the break. Now Tony's up at the table with the break, so maybe he can come back and tie it 2-2. So it'll be a mistaken piece. I beat Johnny Myers even. I get a spot. He beats Johnny Myers. He said he beats Johnny Myers even. I get a spot. He said it was one game.
Oh, this bar is really winding down.
Winding down? What are you talking about?
Dude, there's. You should have seen all the people playing on the nine footers earlier.
Can you see the girls on the mechanical bull?
Where's that mechanical bull? Is that back in the corner?
In the chat room with the VIPs.
Crystal.
What you got in that thing?
Who won? Who's got the 10-7?
That's why he's the locksmith.
All right, Tony Hilla break. Tony Hilla make. All right.
What did
who knows Tony Hilla? What's his nickname?
That's fine. Just tell him I don't need to play no more. I'll take his $100 in the garage.
Yeah, I see a lot of shit talking and less playing.
I don't see any of these guys shit talking.
I really don't even play good ball.
This is coming from TJ.
Like I told him.
Super, he's the. Just call him Super B.
But I pocket balls better than you do.
I agree. But he's going
to
be.
Nope, not cheeseburger. There you go.
At least you can get something in his head.
You don't, what do you, you work at pool, is that it?
I don't have a job. Well, actually, to tell you the truth,
ooh,
I just...
Tony got away with that one, I think.
Oh, really?
Yep, boner.
I've been working fucking...
Nice.
For a while, a long time. If I played every day, fuck, I'd be a hell of a lot better than I am, I'll tell you that.
Tell you what, now that my old lady's gone, the first purchase I'm going to make is a bar box.
I'm not picking on the little
guy. Right in my living room.
Don't speak so
big. That's what I plan on doing.
I went from Johnny's guy. I don't know, 200, 300, 400, I don't know.
I think I'm going to buy the one that he takes to Grand Falls every year.
Why are you picking on anybody, buddy?
Yeah, I'm picking on little Timmy.
So Scott Meyer must be logged in and sleeping.
Dag Ballinger, ITG, internet tough guy.
And what happened to my horse here?
Who is your horse? Does anybody have Junior. A guild in the world of Warcraft so Dax and I can get in? We need gear epic.
Do you know about that stuff?
I haven't played for like 4 years.
Oh, really?
I haven't. Once you, it's funny because it's like you've never seen a video game that cool before. If you know somebody that has like the best gear, and you can run around and just kill everybody. Either that, or you just get tortured.
Oh. Like that. Oh, he's got the one ball there, man.
All right, Tony gets a little tight on a three. He wanted to be a little better. But then again, Tony is the Ginsu, so he can cut that ball. But
the Ginsu.
Yeah, but little lot of movement on his cue ball if he does that. So he's got the one ball. Oh my god.
That just doesn't sound right. To me, that doesn't sound right at all.
Ooh, we got away with us getting seen the six ball.
Perfect.
Shot. Shot by Thrilla Hilla.
Has either of these guys missed yet?
Yeah, both have actually made critical mistakes and given the other person an extra game. Excellent shot.
Excellent shot.
Great out, Tony. Great out.
All right, good shooting by Tony Hilla. Excellent shooting. 2-2.
Nice shooting, Tony.
2-2. Good shooting.
This Dax is a pro at this already.
Yeah, I got a little lesson from Kev. I've been rocking this for like the last, what time did I get here? 6 o'clock? No, I got here at like 5.
You've been on here since 5 o'clock?
Yeah, probably a little later because I came in and hung out for a while.
Awesome.
But man, it's been a lot of fun. I love it.
Yeah, it's good times.
I love it. Uh-oh.
One more time.
It's your break, dude. Your break, Tom.
But, yeah, that's been a lot of fun.
I'm just kidding.
2-2.
I watched someone foul on the break earlier, but not hitting four balls to a rail. But the rule was is that that person still got to re-break.
What?
Who's really?
Why would that be?
John's rules. Well, might as well not even have an illegal break then, right?
Like that person. John probably just likes it personally.
Well, oh,
no. You have to have an illegal break because you can't have that.
All right. Michael on the break. Right. Makes the ball. He's got control. Good break.
I was in a championship match, and I broke, made three balls and the eight ball. And the guy's like, oh, you made a bunch of balls there. And he's looking down, and you can't see the eight ball. And I reached down, and I was like, well, I made this one. You know, and I was going to spot it. And I turn around to spot it, and he walks over the table and starts scraping the table. And I was like, oh, no, whoa. Well, you won, didn't you? I should have just let it go. And oh, yeah, you should have just let him give me the win. But no, I'm not going to do that. I don't want to do that.
That's fun.
Winners never cheat, and cheaters never win.
Just rip it out of Kevin's hands. Looks like Junior's helping that Junior.
Nice out. It's going to be, it's 2-2 right now.
Yep. And, Junior gets a gear. Gets a gear going. Puts a quick score on Tony. But Tony's break now. He's got an answer. Catches a gear and puts a game in there in about a minute.
Three shooting Orthodox Jews just walked in looking for some action.
All right, scores updated. Michael's up 3-2. Tony Hill is on the rack and the break. looking to tie it up 3-3. So.
Did they gamble? Or is that just Amish? One guy can play pretty good. You should see his little curly things in his hair.
Alright, we got a little father-son banter.
Jack says go to the bathroom.
Get him a bottle.
Yeah.
Yeah, my make-a-wish dream, Kevin. Thanks a lot. That was nice of you to let Dax ruin it.
I should be thanking you guys. I was able to concentrate and get myself into the finals and make
Tony Hilla on the break makes three solids and actually ends up beautiful on top.
You're having good times.
So
popularity.
Hey. You can have this.
No, man.
Here, I'll put them on. I can't tell if my voice is loud or soft or what.
All right, Rich Harris is kind of...
Did you get sweaty on it at all?
No. No, I only keep one on.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so Rich Harris is chirping behind me because he's really sad that he doesn't have the microphone.
I kicked him out of the booth.
Kevin kicked him out of the booth, so now he's going to be upset. Now he's going to go out to his car and hang out there for a while. Tony hits that ball pretty perfectly, actually.
Just seems like neither of these guys ever miss.
Not often. Not often. When they miss, they usually trade misses, you know? So it's, they trade a game back to each other. Nice out, Tony Hilla.
So, some good pool we got here.
Yeah, very good. All right, change of score, 3-3. Tony ties it up, answers Michael Perrin's out there, and now it's Michael's turn.
The way these guys are going, the one that has the last breaks can have a good chance to win.
All right.
And we're going to be, you know, from a further point of view, that's what happens. I mean, that's well advertised.
Well.
All right. Well, Michael breaks dry in game 7, but doesn't leave Tony a whole lot here. So this is still, he's got one little shot, maybe two, up here on the top right. Either the 10 or the 2 ball.
Yeah, he can take choice here.
But both shots are tough. They're long shots to start a game.
Yeah, those are the tough ones where you have that long shot,
right.
First shot right off
first
the bat.
First shot off the bat is the tough one, yep.
So, you know, what do you do with that, right? I walked over to a $5 slot machine. In my car, I played 100 spins at $10 a spin. That's so $1,490. I never hit it one time. I money other than my
taking a look at the table here.
Looks
like he's decided. Alright, yeah, he had a tough open table. I mean, none of that was a gimme, so ends up missing his opening shot. So, Michael Perrin, away we go. I don't know if I care. care to do that when it didn't have to be done. Move the four ball without needing to move it.
It's 3-3.
3-3.
Okay, if you're just with us. Finals. This is the final match of the AA Masters at Tour Stop number 2 at MPA Shooters Billiards in Burnsville. But Tony Hill versus Michael Perrin, race to 8, tied Hill 3-3, tied 3-3. And Michael's in obvious control of this rack. It was a little off though. Come around the 10 ball. There it is, two rails. Beautiful shot. I just gotta stick it. Alright, good out by Michael. Unfortunate for Tony not to have a shot on a dry break, but such is pool. So now he's back at his own break.
Alright. That's my horse.
Supposed to be impartial when you call.
I'm not rooting for anybody.
Well, Locksmith, this is going to be turn out to be a sweat match for sure.
All right, Tony's break. See if he answers here.
That one could hurt.
You're up, man.
Okay, Tony Hill has scratches in that rack there, but a lot of balls come up to the head string here, or past the head string, so.
Well, look at all them balls that came up here.
So, kind of a different game. Not a lot of trouble. Fairly, pretty open table. Play there.
Yeah, that
doesn't move
smart
the ball,
play.
Cue ball around a lot, and just plays it right in the side.
Oh.
I would have too. That's what I want to know too. Okay.
Old jumpy's coming out.
That's funny. All right, obviously. All right, Michael tries to jump it. Foul.
I like that.
For Tony. Shouldn't, the way it looks, shouldn't be a problem, but still 8 balls to go.
True ambassadors to the game of pool. Tony walks up and Tony walked up and asked Junior, "Did you hit that with your stick?" Or and Junior just went, "Oh nope, that was a foul. That was a foul."
And they're good friends, so they're gonna obviously become 100% honest with one another.
I like that.
Yeah, absolutely. Good sportsmanship. It's getting very lost today, so we gotta hold on to all those little cues.
Well, this one's gonna be tied up in no time. Don't mind Dax, he's just playing with something under the table there.
Get there. Alright, it's either going to play two rails out or draw out one rail. Looks like two rails. Perfect.
Beautiful.
And a good angle too, so.
Silky smooth there.
A little inside English.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, yeah.
Perfect. Two rails out. Nicely done. Tony Hilla takes care of the 8 balls that needed to take care of. All right. In a race to 8, 4-4.
Halfway home.
Yeah.
It's a new match, and it's a race to 4 here. Seems like it's a new match every time you guys swap a game. It's like earlier I had a match where I played this guy and whoever broke lost every single game, and then it came down to the last game and he broke. Made 2 or 3 balls and then I got out on him and I was
so the turn won the match.
Yep.
Yeah, that's weird.
As soon as the tides changed, why, that's when the match ended. Gotcha. We got
April Larson?
Larson, yeah. What's
her
dad's
name? Over there, Dave Larson.
Dave Larson's
playing. Across the room, Dave Larson's over there playing.
Playing Junior Prestigard there, and the winner of that is going to move on and play Chris Hammer in the finals in the B-side.
Those are pretty good groups right there.
Hey, that little Prestigard kid, he's a pretty good shot, too.
Is that him?
Yeah.
That's not him.
Yeah, it's no, J.D. It's Prestigard. It's Josh's boy.
Yeah, I know. But
Josh Jr.
I know both of them.
Yeah, that's him.
This doesn't look like him from over here. Yeah, he's become a good little shooter. I've known him forever. They're all better than me now. Jeez.
Yeah, there we go.
Well, easy come, easy go. Junior snaps another one down. That's about a minute worth of running.
So I've noticed something here in Minnesota at these tournaments. Nobody gives up that 8-ball. When you're straight in like that?
Actually, for me, I've seen the opposite. People do give up the 8-ball a lot, but now it's become
tighter?
A little tighter, maybe. Yeah. I've seen it both ways. A lot of guys, I just watch a guy give up three games to Junior. So.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah, he just walked away.
Yeah, he walked away. He didn't give up 3 8-balls, he just gave up 3 games.
Did he have to leave or something? Or?
No, he just got mad at missing a shot.
Who was that?
That was Robert.
Robert Mua?
No.
Robert Schifino.
Yeah.
That's who it is.
Schifino or whatever.
Shapino.
Shapino, yeah, Shapino.
Hmm. I don't know. I would, I don't think I could ever do that.
No, me neither.
That's a pretty decent spread.
Good break by Tony. Balls are wide open.
Should be. Well, from what I've been seeing of these two guys playing,
he's ready to get the 12 or 15, and at an angle we could get this, run it down to the 9. And that's a struggle, well, if he goes straight, which I would imagine, but he can make the deuce, right? Deuce or the 4.
Yeah, he can see both of those, I'm thinking.
Mm-hmm. He's taking the 7.
A good shot. I like that shot a lot. Just took the trouble brawl right out of it. I like his attitude.
That's what the 4-3 was for the 7 to go away.
Yeah, that was a great attitude.
I give it was funny that locksmith in Minnesota, I give the 8 a few times and then nope, and watch them miss, laughing my what off.
Yeah.
So I was talking to the old man in the finals, about that same thing. He's like, I haven't seen anybody giving up the 8 ball. I mean, I do that all the time, and people do that to me all the time down in South Dakota. And he come around and got straight on an 8 ball, and I was like, ah, that's good. First game, he looks at me, and I was like, you're good. He rack him up. Sir racks him up, breaks, and the second game, I don't know how it ended up, but he ended up on the 8 ball, and it was pretty straight, but it was about 16 inches away from the 8 ball, and the 8 ball was probably about 48 inches away from the corner pocket.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was about ready to go ahead and give it to him, but then I just kept my mouth shut and sat back, and sure enough, he rattled the 8 ball.
Right.
Left it right in the jaws.
What the?
You're back. Say hi.
Hi.
That's Gay, our lovely cocktail server.
Sure, whatever. Woo!
Fire one.
Are you off work now?
Yes, I am.
Awesome.
Yes.
Fire one.
All right, so you're going to give me your phone number?
I don't know. What do I say to that?
You say yes.
Like, I actually don't have a phone.
You
no.
Say 1-507, yada, 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 yada.
507.
Isn't Minnesota a 507 state?
No. 612 Minneapolis, 651 St. Paul.
612
South, 763 North.
You guys got so many area codes. We got one area code in South Dakota.
Oh, really?
605. That's it.
We got.
How do you know?
Kevin, she wants a
5 or 6.
She's gonna do a naked layout after this game.
Oh, how much are you gonna pay me?
That's what I'm saying. You see how many?
A couple hundred thousand.
37 viewers right now.
Really? See?
You can get more than that.
I wonder who's watching.
First.
There's like 37 other pool halls.
No, most. There are Lee Hewagens on here. A couple guys from South Dakota. I think we should
potentially command my dreams.
You know, you guys can send some money through PayPal, and we'll see if Gay will get out there in between matches and do a little dance for you guys or something.
She's not the type of girl.
We keep it family oriented.
Only in a perfect world.
I clean up.
Well, I struck out. I got no phone number.
I wasn't thinking you were going to get one anyway.
Neither was I. But like I said, I'm not from here, so I don't care, right?
She's still in junior high, so I mean.
Junior high. I didn't realize they let 16-year-olds work at a bar after midnight.
Well, you know, she graduated early. Suda cum laude.
Oh, she's a smart one then, huh?
She's really smart. This shot's a fucking tough fucking shot right here. He's got a fucking nut scratch and he's sitting inside and holding.
That was a great shot.
Yeah, I was gonna accept that shot.
Jeez.
Man.
That was an awesome shot. He had to play that perfect on both ends.
Get down, Tony. Standing up, get fucking confident. She's fucking balling.
Well, I don't know.
These guys swap games again.
Good out, Tony.
It's now a race to three.
Hey, man, that was a hell of a... Hey, those last two shots, brother.
Shit myself.
Those last two shots.
One more time.
There's always one more time.
Josh Prestigard. We gonna discuss this race to 30 some more?
Everybody's scared.
Scared? Please, come now.
Tell Marge.
It is delayed.
The speaking is right. It's from the shooting.
What's that?
There's just like, is there a couple seconds delay from the difference of the like the chat room compared to the pool?
No, but yeah, if you're watching if you're actually watching the live stream, like they're probably just now seeing the break out there in chat world.
Who's Bart? Oh, that's Kevin, right? Is that what that is? Broken RN 25? Is that Kevin?
BRKNRN 25?
X.
No.
Who is it? Well, I guess Dex.
I think it's a rename.
Oh, that was... It's a Kevin still?
Yeah, I think he renamed it.
Shit, they did it.
So, did you guys
probably have the
realize it went off? Did it go off air or that you know of?
What?
For you guys?
No.
Must just have had a.
Somebody say it did?
Yeah, Jimmy Leslie Murphy about an hour ago. And then I know Scott said something about, or I guess that was around 5 o'clock. I think that was about the same time Scott said it was down too. He sent me a text. Must have just went down on out in Streamland because it was up here the whole time, wasn't it?
Yeah, I didn't have a problem at all.
It was storming, wasn't it?
Oh, all right. Rich,
yeah.
We have a request.
Yo, Adrian.
You gotta do it one more time.
Yo, Adrian.
Yeah, that's good. I like that. That's good stuff.
Sit down, Rich.
Did I do good?
You did awesome. Did awesome.
Dax knows I'm Jones.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Get after it.
What time is it? 1:11.
1:11.
Yeah. got my horse going here. This is awesome. My horse playing for the Cowboys.
Jeez. This Facebook is just...
Facebook, yeah, it's got to be crazy.
Gone wacko.
It's got to be ridiculous trying to look at it on a phone. I couldn't even imagine trying to keep up with it with it in a tournament and stuff like that. I mean, if that was, like, removed, then you put Facebook up there and stuff like that as live chat for the stream and stuff like that.
Tanner Pruis, hey, bro. You still, obviously you're probably still out in Deadwood. But he's probably not even in the chat room. I'm talking like he's in the chat room. He's actually blasting me on Facebook.
Is he going to make this deuce up? Not where it hit the 12. Gotta fucking not hit the 12. Good shot. Good fucking shot.
Jeez. Yeah. Someday I'm gonna be that good.
Sweet time when you practice. Good shots on it. What's the score? 6-5 now. Yo, Adrian, you buying breakfast?
I believe 6-5. Well, South Dakota had a good showing today out here at the NPA Tour Stop. Chris Hammer's in the finals. I made it to the finals.
Yeah.
What's the score now? Change of score?
It's 6-5.
Oh, what do I got to do?
Click on that.
Double click this.
Well, I mean, oh shit. Where is it? Is it on the go?
No. Double click on this. Change the score. I always just keep it up. Who scored?
Then you can either minimize it or close it, whichever one. And then hit go. See, this screen here is what's showing live right now. And this screen is what's going to be showing live when you hit the go button.
Alright. Oh boy. Are you guys excited for that? Is that what you're waiting for?
Low, 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 low.
Tony wasn't a cocky loudmouth.
Who is that?
It's Dennis Arcolo.
Is that Dennis or is it Manny Chow?
Dennis Arcolo.
Is it?
Yep.
That's a good picture,
don't,
huh?
Don't play that, man.
Look at that. That's, POV that's, pool balls.
That might be the best player in the world right there. He's he's in the trio of my. He's it for me.
You know what? No, for that's not dough. That's not Dennis. That's Santos Sembojan.
Well, that's all right. That's fine. I'm still betting on him, too. Just because he looks like him. But Dennis Arcolo is Darren Appleton, Van Bunny. Yeah, there's a bunch of guys that any kind of, for a tournament can win.
Santos says, I like the POB pool pan page. I like how we wrote that POB pool pan page. Oh, Michael is back to the table.
Thank you.
lot of support from you fans out there. I do appreciate it.
This is a spot where he, you know, if he pulls the trigger.
They make those nice little cuts that are frozen onto the rail. They make them look easy, don't they?
Where he was, he might have wanted to shoot the four ball to get the deuce out of there. And then I have the five. But you know, he's got a lot to just get the bank right here to get down.
Beautiful. Nice touch. Nice touch. Yeah, Locksmith, I can attest for Hill not being cocky or loud.
He's too good.
Tony is a gentleman that carries a big stick.
He's a jerk. He's one of the nicest guys you ever meet.
Yeah, both these guys are great guys.
Good sport, good dude, good player.
All right, so this score is now 6-6. Oh, it is a race to two. Hit go. And the ball falls.
Yeah, there's something dropped there. Something dropped.
Junior's probably very happy with that. He's had a two or three dry breaks so far this match, and he's not real happy about them. You can't hardly be happy when you dry break on these diamond tables as active as the rails are.
Well, you gotta give him a couple games, so. Stupid, I should have just.
He's gonna go after the six ball here. And he got it.
Yeah, he can make that.
Yeah.
He can make that, shoot the one, run into the 10, get on the 5, or just slide right down there. 4-8,
Yeah, that four ball is going to be the last ball for sure.
Oh, I forgot about the deuce. But, you just get down there and make the five.
He'll put the deuce in the other side pocket.
He might just shoot the four, maybe if he doesn't get on the deuce right.
Perfect.
But he can run into the 12 ball.
Yeah, exactly. He can crack into that 12 ball. It's going to stop the cue ball.
If he doesn't like that, he can always just shoot this and get it, bring it back.
Left himself just a wee bit of an angle to us so he could keep that cue ball down there.
Super dry. Whoa. That's a.
Tony looks away like he couldn't believe that fell in. Nice shot. All right, so it's 7-6. Junior's on the hill. All right.
Yeah. Say, do we, what'd they do? Oh, there we go.
Yeah, you're good.
Forgot,
you're good.
I keep forgetting. There you go.
This is just a one set match, right?
Yep. First and third.
Winner gets first, loser gets third.
Get a ball. Man, it is straight fucking gang rape.
Wow. Look at that table.
Pardon my language.
That, look at that table. There's not a ball within 4 inches of another ball.
Seven balls with a head string. It's horrible. Yeah, you're welcome. Send your donations.
All right.
Feeling good. What about early? Go to school.
Nice shot. I'm gonna start calling this guy Junior Silk because he's silky smooth.
Where's you? What do you expect? Tournament, Junior.
Can't fucking get out on that one. Stop out. Big as 7'6" me.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Got anything to say to the crowd here?
Junior win, Tony?
Huh?
No.
Don't bury your head in your... Looks like you're crying.
Yes, Junior
won. I am.
You got a minute for me?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. I want to give you a little bit of an interview. You got first place in the AA, right?
In the AA?
AA Masters, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Awesome. That's because we're not good enough to be called Masters in South Dakota.
We have a young Tony Zierman.
So, right here we have Junior. He is the champion in the AA Masters division. That was a great match you had there.
Yeah, it was a good match. Fortunately, you know, I capitalized on some of Tony's mistakes because I wasn't breaking very good in that match. But, you know, it was a good match. I need to work on my break, though, that's for sure.
Well, he had a few breaks that, you know, didn't come up very well, like that last one, for instance. I mean, every ball on the table, there was not 4 inches. There was 4 more inches apart every single ball.
Exactly. So I definitely got fortunate there. Another game changer was that shot where he had on the side, and he came up just he hit that tit right there for him to go up 7-6, and I believe his break.
Yep.
And that was a complete match changer right there. But
yeah, that was a big change right there. Huge.
Sure. Yeah, no doubt. Other than that, I got a lot to work on. You know, it was a great tournament, but definitely got a lot to work on to improve my game and to get better. But
well, I tell you what, if you have a lot of work to improve your game, I want to see that when you improve it, because I was over here telling these guys that I got a new nickname for you. I'm going to call you Junior Silk because you're silky smooth with that stick. I mean, those games, it was back and forth. It's a race to 8. 2 games later, it's a race to 7. 2 games later, it's a race to 6.
Yeah,
2 games later, it's a race to 5. It was just back and forth. And I don't know how many. You must have ran 4 racks. He must have ran 4 racks.
Yeah.
Or 5.
Yeah.
Maybe you guys maybe missed 3 times in the whole set each or something, and the other guy got out each time.
Yeah. You know, it's all when it's alternate break, it all comes down to the break. like, you know, it's the most important shot of every game. And, you know, like I said, I wasn't very happy with how I broke, you know, today a lot. But, I mean, I broke okay in some matches, but there's some inconsistency. Like I said, I got a lot to work on. But, you know, I'm very fortunate to come out with the win. And, you know, other than that, I'm happy.
Well, you know, that's what happened to Shane last week. He came through the loser side. Got to the championship against Demetrius.
Yep.
Mowed through him in the first set. I think it was 9-4 or 9-3. And the second set, his breaks just came up dry, and that cost him the match. Demetrius beat him, and Demetrius was only getting one game on the wire.
Yeah, exactly. You know, SVB, he's known as one of the best players in the world, and you know, Demi, kudos to him because he's one of the top players in Minnesota. But you know, when your break's not working for you, that goes to show. Just like last weekend, you know, even Shane being like I said, one of the best players in the world. If your break's not going, you know, right. You know, anybody can beat you that, you know, can run out.
Especially at your guys' level. Because you guys run, you miss a shot and the other guy's out almost every time.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean.
And like that shot where you came back over here to break out the six ball and you nicked it and kind of tied him up tighter. And I was looking at it, I was like, oh, he's going after that six ball this time, and sure enough, just perfect. Kicked it out of there, rolled up, had perfect shape.
Yeah, it was like, I think I tied it up like that, and then I had to go for it again.
Fortunately, you got perfect.
Yeah, exactly. You could put it that way, but.
Well, it looks like there's a big wad of cash over here for you, and it looks like Nate's got some Calcutta money, too, so.
Thanks again to John Sitch for running the tournament. I appreciate it. Like, you're from Sioux Falls, right?
Yep, Sioux Falls, okay. South Dakota.
I appreciate you guys coming out, you know, doing the live stream and everything, you know, for all the viewers that, you know, they're able to watch it over the internet. That's cool for them, too, so I appreciate you coming out as well.
Awesome. Hey, I appreciate you being on my stream, man. It's a pleasure meeting you.
Absolutely.
I'll be up here more often. I'm coming up November 9th for sure. That's on the schedule for Two Stooges.
Oh, okay.
So hopefully we get to
awesome.
See you there.
Definitely see you again for sure.
It's been a great time, and I just can't say enough. The buzz just keeps getting bigger and bigger every week I go out and stream. The buzz is just
awesome.
Picking up.
Yeah,
so
hey, if you enjoy it, you know, keep doing what you're doing. You know, you get to hang out with the pool players and whatnot, and it's
fun. I got into the finals this week too. I was in the finals in the sea. Yeah, I was in the sea. You know, I'm just a streamer, but hey,
it doesn't matter. Now I'm
in the B. So
nice. You got bumped up. Hey, as long as you keep progressing, right?
Right. I got fifth and sixth last week in the C, and then this week I got to the finals. And when I was at fifth and sixth place, John's like, "Well, we're bumping you up anyway." And I was like, "I guess I might as well try to win the thing then and get the most I can." And
yeah, no question.
So second place is all right for me. I mean, it's awesome.
Nice word.
I had a great time, and you know, it's pool players like you that are going to keep me coming back. You know,
cause I appreciate
you guys bring
that.
The viewers,
really,
and you guys are true ambassadors. You know. Even like when Tony, can't remember, he had asked you something on your jump shot,
mm-hmm.
where you fouled, you hit the seven ball first,
yeah,
and he didn't see it, and he's like, "Did you hit that with your cue stick?" And you're like, nope, that was a foul.
I mean, what a basketball. I mean, that was true sportsmanship right there.
Oh, of course.
That's what it's all
you
about.
You know, you know, there's always players out there, you know, that some aren't honest, some are honest. Stuff like that eats at me. You know, I just, you got to be honest. Or, in my opinion, it's the right thing to do is be honest, you know.
And one thing that my father always told me is cheaters never win, winners never cheat. And it's true. It all boils down to that. You might win once in a while when you cheat, but it's going to come back on you.
Yeah. I believe in karma, so I mean, you know, if I wasn't honest on that shot, I might have not even, you know, I might have not won the match. I might have won the match, but when it comes down, you know.
But you feel better. You feel better when you win and you know you won legit and you don't have to worry about
that. Yeah, it's not even about feeling better. It's the right thing to do, period.
Right.
You know, so.
And I love that about you guys. You guys are great sportsmen out here, and
Yeah, I'll be coming up here as much as I can. And awesome. And you know, you made me $20 too. I had a sweat bet tonight on the stream
with one of the
it was
I was wondering
Bob
why you're giving me some nucks in between.
Yeah.
Okay.
It was somebody from Minnesota, Bob Bartlett. Yeah,
Bob Bartlett. He took it. Yep. God dang you, Bob. All right.
He took Tony, I took you, and he was taking Tony by two, and I said, well, I think Ray's going to get him by two, and he's like, let's sweat it out for $20, and I was like, well, you want Tony by two, I want Ray by two, we'll just sweat it out even, Steven, and you bet, we'll do it, $20, so hopefully I get to see that $20 in my PayPal account here by tomorrow and over the weekend.
He'll take care of you, no doubt.
Yeah, I have no doubt in my mind. All you guys up here in Minnesota are true ambassadors of the sport, and I couldn't be happier being here.
Yeah, I appreciate you coming. Like I said, you know, these are great tournaments, and appreciate you, John, and everybody putting on the events, and it's great for all the viewers that, you know, sit at home, watch pool or whatever, you know. It's good, you know.
Maybe we can get you to travel down to South Dakota for a match sometime. We'll put up an action match or something, you know.
Like I said, I still got a lot of work on, so maybe in the future here, yeah, for sure.
I've been trying to get Josh to come down here. I got a motel room that I can give him, and I'll feed him, and I want him to play a 30-game match. I actually want to get two Minnesota players and two South Dakota players, have them do a Scotch doubles and singles.
Oh, okay.
So
nice.
Two singles matches and a Scotch doubles match, you know, a couple hundred or 500 each match or something, you know.
Okay. Isn't there a guy named goes by SVB over in Sioux Falls?
Well, yeah, and if he was around, I'd probably try to get him as one of my horses too, you know, but hey, just like Demi did last week,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
Possible, right?
Yeah, like I said, I got a lot to work on, but I'm coming for you, SVB.
Sounds great.
But anyhow, thanks for having me, and I look forward to seeing you again soon.
Thank you, Ray. Or Junior.
Yeah, thank you.
Alright. Here's
your cup letter. Alright,
that was Junior with me here, and looks like coming up here on the stream table next, we're going to have Chris Hammer and J.D. Prestigard. J.D. Prestigard and Chris Hammer. Somebody got Chris out of the car, woke him up. All right, well, I'll be right with you here, guys. I'm going to do a quick check here. I'll be right with you.
You first.
Yeah,
you first. When are you first?
Josh, do it. Hey, you better push the record button on this one.